Meet Belle, our new German Shepherd puppy. Meet Cinder, the older 7.5-year-old chocolate lab. Join us as we bring these two together, train them, learn from them, and become a family. Oh yeah, and look out for cuteness. This video is made possible by RangerRob Poopy Bags, available on Amazon right now. Hello everyone, and welcome to the Cinder and Belle Show. Before we get going, I want to let you know that we have to look at our pet safety. And one of the problems we have in Arizona is we have a pool. Now our new puppy, German Shepherd, has actually fell in the pool about 5 times. And then luckily we've always been there. But it scares the dickens out of us because when she does, it's usually at the other end of the pool. And so we have to teach her how to swim. And we have to teach her how to get out of the pool by ourselves. Because one of these days, they'll both be outside. And the problem is the dogs are wrestling and playing. And she accidentally gets knocked into the pool. And she swims really well. But the important thing is teaching the German Shepherd how to get in and out of the pool. What we're about to show you is Sherry and I putting the dog in the pool at the other ends at different locations and teaching her how to get out. So I hope you enjoy this video. Please know that we're not being cruel and we tried to make it a pleasant experience. Every time she made it, she got praised, got treats, and we did it several times. So just a little bit of warning of don't think we're being mean to the dog. We love our dog with all our hearts. And if she was to drown in our pool, it would break our hearts. So if you have a pool and you got a new puppy, I suggest you do the same thing we're doing. So let's get on with the show. All right, guys. So we're going to do 6 drops here. So this is the very first one. And I faced her towards mom so she could see which way to go. And we urged her on. I want you to also note that we didn't remove the vacuum in the pool because we want her to know that she needs to swim over that hose. Alright, this is number 2. If you notice, we're going to different locations in the pool and facing her in different directions. Once again, she has to swim over the hose and she did wonderful. This is our 3rd time, and it went around the curve a little bit, so she can't see the exit that easy. Once again, she did this with flying colors.
Good girl, yes, yes. Look at you, that was such a good girl. That was great.
This was number 4. We're just trying to keep distractions going, hoses in the pool, Cinder swimming, noises, the whole works. And once again, she's getting the idea to go into the back corner and get out on the steps. So yeah, she's doing great. This is number 5, and it's getting a little trickier now. We're not calling her anymore, and we're just putting her in another location so she knows which way to go, and she did really good. This is number 6, and this is getting to be more trickier. We are leaving the corner so she can't see Sherry, and she can kind of see Sherry off to the left. And you see she gets a little bit confused, and that concerned us. So Sherry did come back and then call her back, but she wasn't panicking. She was doing great. All right, guys, number 7, this is, we removed Sherry out of sight completely, let her go in the pool and see how she did. And this time with no calling, nothing. And this is the result. And we were very happy about that, guys. Safety.
Good girl. No, come.
All right, now that the big swims are over with, now what we're doing is reassuring her with treats and stuff to come near the pool and not to be afraid that she's going to be put in all the time. So it's just enticing her over, letting Cinder play, keep giving her treats, and reassure her that everything's okay and don't be afraid. Last but not least, we've been making her do a couple of small swims near the steps, trying to also try to teach her that the pool can be fun and a pool she can play in, but she's not really getting it too much yet. But we got her in the pool, reassure her, get her wet, kind of used to it. Also realize it's almost 100 degrees out and the pool will keep her cool. So this is one of three little swims we had her do. Just give her different conditions, let her figure out how to get those 4 feet working together. This one, she was kind of working her front paws more than her back paws, so this wasn't her best one. Her second try was a little better, didn't go quite as far, but she was using all 4 feet better. This was her third run. She went out a little ways, said far enough, came back using all 4 feet pretty good, and we'll do probably one more. And for her last run, she was kind of working her front feet a little hard. I think she was a little in the panic mode, so we made this her last one. She did really well. So we got her to one end of the pool, came back by herself. Of course, Cinder jumping all around her. But yeah, she did great. And of course, we've got to keep Cinder running. She could do this all day long. She just loves to go in the pool, get a ball, and bring it back out. That's her mission in life. So once again, we just kind of played around the pool a little bit, kept enticing her over to the edge just to realize that we're not going to put her in the pool every time she comes over here. So we're just kind of working on some snuggle time and relaxing around the pool without being afraid that she's going to be thrown in. And takes a little bit of enticement, and she's a little nervous. She thinks she might go swimming again, but rest assured she didn't have to go anymore.
Doing Cinder.
By the way, you gotta love those ears. They're amazing. Now you know why my palm trees always look so bad. They're a perfect butt scratcher. So Cinder does this all the time. So I'm glad this tree's getting a little bigger. So I hope you enjoyed this show. Please subscribe and we'll talk to you later. Thank you very much for watching our video. Please take the time to like, subscribe, and share our videos all over the whole wide world. Thanks.